Hey guys, how you doing? I'm doing good. I do not have much to say. I just want to come on to say hello and to let you guys know that I am far from home. Far, far, far from home. I took a little road trip, just like it was very random. I was going through a lot, still am. I want to go home. Well, I shaved under my arms, just so you know. You guys probably thought like there was something wrong with me because I just kept letting it wolf and stuff, but I just got lazy. Yeah, I've been going through a lot, so I decided I needed a break, and I'm far. I would say where I'm at, but I don't want to. Just know I'm in a country. Like a Bama. Not Alabama or nothing like that. I was just saying I'm a country Bama. I'm getting clues. Guys, alright. So, what's been going on with me? Not much. I've been doing good as far as, smoking. I never told you guys, but I quit smoking. It's been like 2 months since, some change. Along with drinking, but I have to say that I did drink a couple of times, maybe 5-6 times in between the 2 months of when I quit, because I went to my cousin's engagement party and they had sangrias and I had some, and then I started craving beer, so I started drinking beer. But like I said, it's only been like 5 times since I drank within 2 months, which is pretty good for me because I used to drink all the time. When I say all the time, I mean breakfast, lunch, dinner, snack. Oh, guys, I'm sick of this video camera because my mouth is not moving on point, you know? I feel like I am in a kung fu flake, right? So, what am I doing right now? I'm just chilling. Most everybody left the house to go do something, and I chose to stay here because I wanted to, I wanted to do a couple of things, which I haven't done yet. I just wanted to come on here to talk to you guys. This is probably like my 11th time making a video, no lie. Every time, it's not even funny, every time I recorded, it was either a whole bunch of nonsense, like the first 3 minutes of this video, because this is just nonsense, or like it just deleted off of the webcam. I tried it on another webcam, which is much faster, but it froze on me, so I just give up. I'm back to this one. My arm is killing me. Oh gosh. Yeah guys, I want to tell you so bad what's been going on with my little sister, but when I get back home, I'm gonna make a video with her, and she's gonna tell you. I feel really bad because she met this stalker. Okay, he seemed really normal. He seemed so cool, everything, and I kind of pushed her to him. I was like, "Oh, he's really cool. I know him. Da 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 da. There's nothing wrong with him," and she kind of was like, "Okay," and she went to the movies with him. And she was like, "Oh, I'm so glad that you told me to go to the movies with him. He's so cool." And I'm like, "Yeah, see, I was right. I thought I really made a love connection. Boy, was I wrong. This dude is psycho, alright? But I'm gonna let my sister tell you. Sorry, guys. I'm like so out of shape that like my bones just like pop out of socket like easy." Yeah. Yeah, so anyway, about me. I would get into some things, but I don't want to get into things too soon. Everybody around me is getting married. Kind of felt bad about it and stuff, but, sorry guys. I'm going to let my time come. I know it's coming soon. Don't hate. Congratulate. Okay, guys, give me a second. Yo, guys, I'm so sorry, yo. I feel like an old lady, dog. Like, for real. Like, my body is killing me. Oh, my hair. It's not natural. Can you see? Back to the kinks. Hope you guys like it. There was somebody that wrote me and told me that he hates my natural hair. He says that it looks like I'm dirty or disheveled or something. Nah, he didn't really say dirtied. But he said that he prefers me with straight hair. But it's okay. You could think what you want. The person that loves me loves my natural hair. And everything about me. Even my shopping bags. Really. Okay, guys. Let's get to the meat. The meat of this video. I just decided to tell you this. Just because. Somebody wrote me on YouTube the other day. And I don't know if it was a girl or guy, but they told me that there's somebody that I'm subscribed to that apparently I need to unsubscribe to. And they were telling me how this person is cheating on his girlfriend and having SEX with all these random computer girls. And I'm just like, why are you telling me this? Like, in my head. Gosh. Sorry. I'm kind of like questioning, why are they telling me this? Because I'm just subscribed to the guy. There's nothing going on between me and him. So anyway, this guy is really cool. Anyway, he's just like so chill. And I like to hear what he's got to say. And that's it, you know? He never tried to holler at me. So I responded. I was like, oh, I'm so sorry for your family member. And, you know, she doesn't deserve to be cheated on. Nobody does. Like, she's beautiful. Like, you know. And then I get a response back like, what? Are you smitten by this guy? Oh, if you'll deserve it when you get hurt and saying all this stuff. I'm just like, whoa, where'd that come from? Really? You're probably watching my video right now, but really, where did that come from? What did I say to you? I didn't say anything about this dude. I just follow him. And then you're telling me I need to unsubscribe to him if I don't want to be investigated? Really? Since when has YouTube become that serious? Where a subscription is like somebody cheating. Like, really? Tell him to get off of YouTube if that's the case. But don't tell me to unsubscribe to somebody that I want to be subscribed to. Shoo. Anyway. I just got my mood like totally down here. Oh. So I went to this church thing today, right? And let me tell you, I left as soon as I got there. I was so pissed off. Let me tell you. Alright, so we go to this church thing. Last night I went to this church thing. It was cool. It was free. Excuse me. I had a good time. And they were having something today. It's like a, I don't know what it was. Today it was just an event, I guess. And last night they said, tomorrow's event is going to be free entrance, but $3 donation. So I'm just like, okay, I guess you go in for free. If you choose to give a donation, you give it. Okay, cool. So I'm not the one that's from out here, so I wasn't really paying attention. I had the money and everything. I could have paid for all of us that went. Sorry, guys. Yeah, so I could have paid for everybody, right? We get there. And we get to the door. Some dude is sitting at the door talking about, you got to pay. I'm like, all right, well, we're not even sure that we're staying. We just came to drop off my cousin because she has to perform. And he's like, well, you're not coming through the door unless you pay. I'm like, well, shoot. These two got to go to work. They're the ones that drove me here. Like, we're not even staying, really. So what you mean we gotta pay? And I was like, didn't they say free entry, $3 donation? Like, if that's the case, just say $3 entrance fee. Don't tell me it's a $3 donation. Like, and it doesn't say required. It says requested on a yo, I wish I had the flyer. It says $3 donation requested. There's a difference between required and requested. Okay, now this is why I hate going to church functions, because, you know, look how easy it was for them to turn all of us down because we didn't give them the $3. Like I said, I had the $3. I had lots of $3. Okay? I just didn't give it because the dude was being rude. Then my aunt comes up. My aunt, she got 8 beautiful kids. Ooh, they're so beautiful. Yeah. She had all her kids. They was going to perform or whatever. And I had one of her daughters with me. And we were dropping her off. And my aunt was like, I'll pay for them. I'll pay for them. And he's like, they can't come in. They can't come in. And I'm just like, hold up, mister. Is it that serious that we're standing at the door? Like, we're not even inside. Like, shoot. And then my aunt was like, no, Diane, come inside. I'm like, no, I am not going inside there. You know, because I have a lot of pride. I know that's bad. But if you're rude to me over something like that, $3 for a church function. And if anything, we're at church. You should be more, you know, I don't know. Maybe I put too much on church people. And I think they're supposed to be perfect. And they're not. For real. I don't know. That's why I don't like going to church. But I could praise the Lord from home. Because I seem to have a problem with everybody at every church that I've been to. I just thought it was rude to embarrass us. Because everybody turned around and is looking at me and all my cousins like, they don't have $3 to get in? Jeez! No. We do have lots of $3. And we could have gotten if we wanted to. But if you're rude to us, especially to me and my fam, you ain't getting our money. Okay. I don't even know where that came from. But yeah, back to another story. Or the story that I was talking about before. How about no story? How about that? Because I don't have any. I don't have any left. I have lots, but I can't really get into them right now because I want a better camera. I want you guys to see my mouth moving as I speak. I want you to get it. I want you to see me clearly when I tell you these other things. Because when I say they're good, all right? But yeah, I gotta find me peace of mind. Yes, I do. How about that? Let's listen to that right now. It's my favorite song. One of my favorite songs from Lauryn Hill. It's beautiful. I gotta find peace of mind. I gotta find peace of mind. He says it's impossible, but I know it's possible. He says it's impossible, but I know it's possible. Beautiful. Listen to the words. He says there's no me without him. Please help me forget. Please help me forget about him. He takes all my energy. Trapped in my memory. Constantly holding me.
I need to tell you all the pain he's caused.
Let me stop because I hate when people do this on your videos. But whenever you guys get a chance, I want you to listen to Lauryn Hill, Peace of Mind. It's a very old song, but it's beautiful and it's real and it's touching and it's just, oh, gosh, Lauryn, I miss you. Guys, I think it's time for me to go. I've been talking a whole bunch of nonsense and I'm scaring myself. That's how bored I am, okay? I got a couple of things to do, but I don't want to do them. I want to take a nap, but I'm not even tired. I want to eat, I'm not even hungry. I mean, come on. I must be that bored. You know what I'm about to do? I'm about to watch an African movie. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to watch an African movie, and I'm going to write King a letter, because, yeah, that's it. You guys don't know who King is. I'm going to inform you on another video. Yeah. Alright, guys. So, I will talk to you some other time. And, guys, I ask all the time, please forgive me when I don't comment back or write back. Please forgive me. Please, please forgive me. Believe it or not, I'm going to get back to every single one of you guys. Even if it's months from now, I will. Okay, so be patient. I love you. God loves you. And thank you for staying subscribed.